What does a free and open internet really mean? More censorship in China and videos on Instagram that can't be stopped. Tech News Tonight is next.
This is TWiT.
This is Tech News Tonight, episode 268 for Wednesday, February 4th, 2015. This episode is brought to you by Lynda.com. Invest in yourself for 2015. Lynda.com has thousands of courses to help you learn new tech, business, and creative skills. For a free 10-day trial, visit lynda.com/TN2. That's lynda.com/TN2. I'm Megan Maroney. Let's get right to the tech feed. Now with more net neutrality. The internet must be fast, fair, and open. Those are the immortal words of FCC Chairman Tom Wheeler in an op-ed piece on Wired.com today. The piece spells out Wheeler's proposal to reclassify and regulate the internet as a public utility. Now, HBO comedian John Oliver is famous for saying that the only thing more boring than net neutrality is listening to someone talk about net neutrality. But bear with me, because this is big news that profoundly affects all of us. When we first started the net neutrality debate, most of us were spending our time online on a computer, but now we're accessing the web on all kinds of mobile devices, and buried in Wheeler's Wired piece was his plan for these rules to apply to mobile data services as well as traditional internet services. The FCC posted a four-page commission report outlining Wheeler's new rules. We've invited Alex Wilhelm from TechCrunch to talk to us about what this means.
Hey.
Thanks for coming, Alex. So break it down for us. What exactly is Wheeler proposing?
Well, what Wheeler did today was to do what we thought he was going to do and a little bit more. I mean, he signaled during CES in Las Vegas that he's going to go with Title II, which is a regulatory regime. But the inclusion of wireless was a surprise to some. I think a lot of companies hoped that he was not going to do that, but he did. And then also there was work done on interconnection or peering arrangements as part of his plan. It's less strict on that regard, but certainly part of the overall proposal. And we've been looking forward to this day for a long time. I mean, they're going to vote on the 26th, which is coming up, and it's kind of go time. The last year was almost preamble since the FCC lost in court to Verizon, and now their proposal is roughly concrete, roughly understood in the market, and all we need now is the text and the vote. So it's kind of like the culmination, if you will.
Right. So you are an advocate for net neutrality, I assume?
I have a pulse, and I'm not paid by Verizon, so yes, I'm in favor of neutrality.
So this was good news for you today.
I mean, yes, and I want to make a point. Like, I think when Tom Wheeler was appointed, you mentioned the John Oliver segment and so forth, people thought that he was going to be a paper tiger at best and a sellout, most likely. And instead, he's come around to this position after talking to everybody of advocating for and proposing the strongest possible, in his terms, neutrality regulations you could put in place. So really, you know, Tom Wheeler has done a kind of a beautiful job here and has landed the airplane and will probably have the votes to pass this thing. So even though it's been kind of a year of Sturm und Drang, use the old German phrase, I think we kind of got there. And I'm excited by that because I believe the internet matters as a free and open, you know, vehicle for communication.
Right. So we talked a lot about this a couple weeks ago, the Title II. This is what he's putting in forth. So is this really all of Title II, or do you think it's just parts of Title II that he's proposing?
It's just parts. They're going to forbear or kind of ignore parts that don't make a lot of sense. They're not going to do, you know, not going to set rates for what people can charge for internet access and so forth. So they're going to use the parts that they want to and kind of get rid of the rest. And if you read their proposal, they also mentioned Section 706 and Title III. So they kind of have three different legs to stand on here when they go to court, because they'll get sued, of course. And I think they're confident they're going to win. If you go back and read the original Verizon ruling, the first 45 pages or so, the court makes it very clear that they have the authority to do this if they use the proper regulatory structure. And it seems to me, and again, I'm not a lawyer, but they have done that. And so these should be robust laws that will stand up in court. And Title II is part of that. It's a very important part. But it's just one of the about three things I have kind of in the gun, if you will.
Right. So you mentioned lawsuits. Now, AT&T yes. came out earlier this week saying they would sue if yes. he came out. And have they spoken out today about that?
There's been about 14,000 hot takes. I'm presuming that their lawyers are kind of steaming up right now. I mean, Verizon, Comcast, AT&T, and so forth, they're going to go after this, maybe as a group, maybe individually. But they don't like the idea of regulation. They're profit-seeking corporations, and these regulations could limit their ability to derive profit. So that's going to happen. I think they're going to lose, if I had to kind of guesstimate right now. But, I mean, each firm is just kind of gearing up for war. That's kind of, I think, you know, you can't dispute that.
Right. So, I mean, another thing that John Oliver joked about saying, you know, that the internet isn't currently broken and now they're trying to fix it. So is this going to be sort of business as usual going forward with
That's the idea is that this will keep business as usual as business as usual. I mean, the idea here is we're trying to maintain what's worked so far, and we're going to codify that to prevent people from breaking the, you know, just the way the internet works. I mean, if we did allow for paid prioritization or these so-called fast lanes, it would fundamentally shift the way content is delivered to consumers across internet lines. And instead, we're going to have rules that say, no, you can't do that, and you can't block, and you can't throttle, and you can't be abusive. And so, like, if you look back at the way the internet has worked and you're in favor of that, all we're saying in these regulations is we're going to keep it that way. Right. And that's fantastic because it's worked so well for so many years.
Yeah. It's funny. Whenever you read about this, everyone always uses Netflix as the example. Like, it feels like Netflix is an advertiser in the net neutrality debate or something. Well, we want to get our Netflix fast enough. So what you're saying is now we will continue to get our Netflix at the same speed.
Hopefully, yes. I mean, the reason why Netflix matters is because they're like 40% of U.S. internet traffic at peak times because everyone's watching Netflix. So right. That's kind of an important thing to keep in mind. But they're a poster child, but other content companies are coming up next. There will be another Netflix down the road, and that's kind of what matters more. Do you want less buffering now? Yeah, sure. But I mean, what you care about more is that the next Netflix can become, can be born, really, funded and grow, so you have, you know, whatever's coming next without interruption and without the need to kind of, you know, bribe off these large ISPs. And so Netflix is a poster child in several different ways, one of which in that it's a disruptor, and we want to keep the ability to have disruptors growing. And that's why this, the whole thing matters.
Right. So how can we ensure that this is really going to happen? I mean, if there's the Wired op-ed and there's a proposal, and so what happens next? There's the vote at the end
yes.
of this month.
And there are two Republicans, two Democrats, and the commissioner, the chairman, sorry. And so there's going to be a 3-2 vote, I would guess, along party lines, literally. And it should pass. And then once it does, it's off the races in court and so forth. So we're going to see, I think, a relatively easy passage along party lines and then war. And given that the FCC has so minutely laid out their legal case, and I haven't really seen any commentary yet from outside groups that's convincing to me, I think they're going to do fine. But I mean, it's going to be a huge guess. You have a legal budget that can stretch into the billions of dollars, right? So you're going to spend. Because even if you don't think you're going to win, why not try? Why not try to win this one?
Right.
Because the FCC has lost twice legally on different lines, but I mean the same general argument. So I think it'll pass, and then, you know, get out your battle axe.
Right. All right. Well, so should we write our congressman, or is there our congressperson?
Yeah, you know, call, write, email, smoke signal, DM, tweet. I mean, if you keep the noise up, they will care more. Right. But, you know, this is going to be decided in the courts and not in Congress, it appears. Congressional GOP people are really mad at the FCC right now because they didn't want Chairman Wheeler to do this, but he did it anyways because Chairman Wheeler does not give a frack, if you will. He's kind of just doing his own thing.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of sniping, but Congress doesn't really have the authority right now to stop them. There was some talk of different legislative pieces, but so far nothing's come of that. And since the president got what he wanted from the FCC, he would probably veto any bill that would, you know, curb that authority to begin with. So, you know, I mean, keep the pressure up, but I mean, it's kind of out of their hands for the next couple of months.
Well, thank you so much. That's Alex Wilhelm at TechCrunch. What are you working on next, Alex?
Let's see. Box share price, a couple of meetings, karaoke, and then about 4 a.m. we'll cover this again. So it'll be fun.
Excellent. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And coming up, Instagram's gone loopy and one woman's quest to show up on the front door of each and every one of her Facebook friends. Because that's not creepy at all. But first, this episode of Tech News Tonight is brought to you by Lynda.com. It's already February. What are you waiting for? Invest in yourself this year and learn something new with a free 10-day trial to Lynda.com. Lynda.com is used by millions of people around the world and has over 4,500 courses on topics like web development, photography, visual design, and business, as well as software training like Excel, WordPress, and Photoshop. Are you a teacher or a parent trying to understand the technology that students use in the classroom? There are lots of Lynda.com courses that help you stay up to date with the latest educational technology and classroom management techniques. I recommend Google Classroom First Look, iPad Classroom, and Teacher Tips. Whether you have 15 minutes or 15 hours, each course is structured so you can learn at your own pace and on your own schedule from start to finish. And of course, all Lynda.com courses are taught by experts who are accomplished professionals at the top of their field. Do something good for yourself in 2015 and sign up for a free 10-day trial to Lynda.com by visiting lynda.com/TN2. You'll get unlimited access to every course on lynda.com, including access on your iOS and Android devices, plus new courses as they're added each week. That's lynda.com/TN2 to try it free for 10 days. Go ahead. I challenge you to learn something new. Now on to a few more stories we're following today. The Cyberspace Administration of China announced that they will ban internet accounts that impersonate people and also require people to use their real names while blogging, instant messaging, and using some other internet services. This according to the Wall Street Journal. China claims the new restrictions are designed to cut down on fake accounts, but their real names policy is just one of a string of government censorship actions that we've reported over the last few weeks. China is the world's most populated country. It also has the biggest population of internet users at 649 million. But while the use of social media in other countries continues to grow, social media in China has slowed due to this kind of censorship. And now for our daily malware report. Yesterday, we told you about several popular Android games that allegedly contain malware. Today, Google is reporting that those games have been removed from the Google Play Store. In other malware news, Ars Technica Security and Hacktivism blog is reporting a hole in Internet Explorer that could allow attackers to steal login credentials and inject malicious content into your browsing sessions. Microsoft says they're working on a fix and reminds you not to click unknown links and not to visit sites that you don't trust. Now, if you like watching 6-second Vine videos of raccoons stealing food from cats and you love Instagram, then you're going to love this news. Instagram announced today that they're going to start automatically looping the 15-second videos that you can upload to their service. You know who else loves this news? Advertisers. Loop counts on Vine are what advertisers look to determine the popularity of their video ads. And now advertisers on Instagram will be able to do the same. Advertisers will also no doubt appreciate the fact that Instagram gives you no way to pause the video. The looping feature will roll out first at iOS and then the web, and we expect the update to the Android app soon. No word yet on how much of the cut that cute raccoon will get of the ad profits. And finally, have you ever wondered if your Facebook friends were your real friends? Artist Tanya Hollander did. According to a story in The Atlantic, Hollander has spent the last 4 years on a quest to photograph all 626 of her Facebook friends in their own homes. Hollander said the list of friends contained some people she no longer spoke to in real life and some she'd never even met in person. The project is titled Are You Really My Friend? And is scheduled to open at the Massachusetts Museum of Contemporary Art in March 2017. I am thinking of doing the same thing on Twitter, so follow me. I'm at Megan Maroney, and I promise to call before I come over. That's it for this edition of Tech News Tonight. You can subscribe to the show at twit.tv/TN2. Write to us at tn2@twit.tv and watch live every weekday at 4 p.m. Pacific. And if you're not available to watch live, don't worry about it. You can watch us all over the place, including YouTube at youtube.com/tn2. And don't miss our morning news program, Tech News Today, every weekday at 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern. I'm Megan Maroney. Thanks for watching.
Bandwidth for Tech News Tonight is brought to you by cashfly.com.